handling. So if the project is complex, then in that case there will be more number of risks associated with that project. So this model is suitable for complex projects and useful for risk handling. Okay, and here, so when to use this model? So just now I said you need to use this model if the project is a complex one. Then it contains various phases, so it contains multiple loops or phases. So what is loop or phase here? So if you observe this, so this is a spiral, right? So spiral starts at this point and it ends here. So this complete part from this center point to this position, this is considered as one phase or one's loop. And again it starts from here, so, and it ends at this point. This is nothing but phase 2. Then again start from here and end it here. That is phase 3 or loop 3. And this one, again, this is considered as loop 4. Like that, you will have multiple loops or phases in the spiral model. So, these phases are not known at the beginning of the project because they will vary from project to project. Then who will decide these phases? So these phases will be decided by the project manager. So if the project manager is not satisfied with the product after completion of phase 1 or loop 1, then again he will go with the loop 2. So decision will be taken by him. So he is considered as the important person, or he plays an important role in spiral model. Okay, so now let us see the process of spiral model. So if you observe this diagram, you can just find that there are total 4 quadrants in the spiral model. So this is quadrant 1, quadrant 2, quadrant 3 and quadrant 4. So in quadrant 1, first requirements are gathered from the customer. So let us take quadrant 1. So requirements are gathered from customer. And then, so how the requirements are gathered? So communication takes place between the customer and developer, and the developer will gather requirements from customer. After that, so these requirements, they should be identified, elaborated. You need to elaborate the requirements and analyze the requirements. So why we need to analyze the requirements? In order to find out possible solutions. So you need to find multiple possible solutions for this problem or for the project. So here you can just observe, here objectives determination, that means you need to find out the objective of the project and identify multiple solutions. So after analyzing the requirements, find possible multiple possible solutions. And after this second quadrant, so second quadrant, it starts with here you need to, so during second quadrant, from these possible solutions, you need to find one best solution. Okay, so after finding the best solution, here for this solution also there will be risk associated with that, right? So find out the risk associated with this solution. So here, identify the risks associated with the solution and resolve them. So you need to use certain strategies in order to resolve the risks. And build prototype for the identified solution. So at the end of this quadrant 2, you need to build a prototype for the obtained solution or for the selected solution. Next, quadrant 3. So develop next version of the product. So here we selected the solution, right? So for this solution, you need to write code. So this is quadrant 3, where implementation should be done. That is nothing but coding. So once the product is implemented, it should go through testing in order to examine whether the product is, whether the solution which we selected after implementation, if it is working properly or not. So here you need to develop the next version of the software. And during the fourth quadrant, so review and plan for the next phase. So after testing, this will be delivered to the customer, right? So during quadrant 4, so here customer will receive the product and he will evaluate. So he will review the product and evaluation will be done to check whether the product is according to the specified requirements or not. So he specified some requirements, so he will check for those requirements, so whether those requirements are implemented in the product or not. So if the user is not satisfied with the product, or if the project manager is not satisfied with the product, then in that case you need to plan for the next phase. So now we completed this part. So we completed only first phase. So quadrant 1, quadrant 2, quadrant 3 and quadrant 4 are over. So quadrant 1, quadrant 2, 3, 4 are over. So now we completed one loop. So if these people, mainly this project manager, if he is not satisfied, if we want to implement few more functionalities, or if we want to add new requirements to the model, then in that case again you need to go through the second phase. So it starts with this first quadrant and it ends at the fourth quadrant. So like that, number of loops depends on the project manager decision. Okay, so this is how the spiral model works. So coming to, so here you need to go through some terms, that is radius. So radius of the spiral model, next angular dimensions of the model. Why this model is called as meta model? So first, radius of the spiral model. What is meant by this radius? So this is the center point, right? So from center point to the end of the spiral. So end of the spiral means this point. So this gives you radius of the spiral. So and radius of the spiral, so cost of your project depends on this radius. That means if there are more number of loops or phases in the project, then in that case, with increase in the radius, cost also increases. Okay, if there are more number of phases, then cost of this project will be expensive. Next, coming to angular dimensions. So if we complete 180 degrees of the, if we cover 180 degrees, then in that case we say that only two quadrants, or we completed only two portions of the project. Whereas if we complete 360 degrees, then in that case it indicates that we covered all four portions of the model. Okay, so angular dimension, it represents progress of the model. That means how the part that we completed. So the progress of the model is evaluated by taking the angular dimensions of the model. Coming to meta model, why this model is called as meta model means, so it is making use of other SDLC models like waterfall model. Okay, all the phases, so all the quadrants, they are repeated one after, they are implemented one after the other sequentially. So it is using waterfall model and iterative model. So it has multiple loops. So it is taking, so here you can just observe multiple iterations. So it is using iterative models, and prototype is developed at the end of quadrant. prototyping model also. So as it is using multiple models, this model is treated as meta model. So coming to the advantages of spiral model, first advantage is risk handling. So this model is more suitable for the projects where there are more number of risks. Coming to second one, good for large projects. So if the project is very large, then in that case obviously it contains more number of risks. So if this is suitable for risk handling, then it is good for large projects as well. Third one is flexibility requirements. So here usually customers keep on changing the requirements. So at the end of every phase, as the review is conducted by the customer, so if he is not satisfied, then again he will provide few more requirements. So you can add new requirements at the end of every phase or during the beginning of the next phase. So it provides more flexibility. Customer satisfaction is more here because he is able to review the project at more frequently. Like see, just now we discussed same thing. After reaching the end of loop 1, so he can review, and if he is not satisfied, again next loop will be, so again will execute next loop. Okay, so customer satisfaction will be more here. So you need to execute these number of loops until customer is satisfied with the product. And then improved communication. So communication between the customer and developer will be more here. Okay, when compared to remaining model. So communication is improved. So if the customer is satisfied, then in that case, it indicates that the developed product is of high quality, right? So if the quality is not up to the mark, then again he'll suggest few more changes. Similarly, project manager also. So this model will run until both of them are satisfied. So obviously you will get the product with high quality. Next, disadvantages. It is very complex model because there are more number of phases or loops if the project is very complex. Next, it is expensive. So this model is usually not suitable for small projects because model itself is very expensive. Difficulty in time management. So here the number of phases or loops, they are not known at the beginning of the model. So it is not possible to estimate the time also. So we cannot estimate how much time is required to complete the project. So it is nothing but difficulty in time management. So these are few advantages and disadvantages of the spiral model.